गोपी जन वल्ला भागिरी वरधारी यशोदा नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन जमुना तीरा वनचारी जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी जय राधा माधव जय ओम विष्णुपाद परमहंस परिव्रजक आचार्य अष्टोत्तरशत हिज डिवाइन ग्रेस ए सी भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद की इस्कॉन बीबीटी संस्थापक आचार्य श्रील प्रभुपाद की ग्रंथराज श्रीमद्भागवतम की अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की ऑल ग्लोरियस असेंबल्ड डिवोटीज ऑल ग्लोरियस असेंबल्ड डिवोटीज ऑल ग्लोरियस असेंबल्ड डिवोटीज ऑल ग्लोरियस ऑल ग्लोरियस ऑल ग्लोरियस श्री गुरु एंड श्री गौरांग ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय सो रीडिंग फ्रॉम कैंटो 10 चैप्टर 10 Verse number 17. Daridra Saiva Yujyante Sadhava Samadarshina Sadbhikshinoti Tam Tarsham Tata Arad Vishuddhyati दरिद्रस्यैव युज्यन्ते साधव समदर्शिना सद्भिक्षिणोति तं तर्षां तत आराद् विशुध्यति दरिद्रस्यैव युज्यन्ते साधव समदर्शिना सद्भिक्षिणोति तं तर्षां तथा राग विशुध्यति दरिद्रस्यैव युज्यन्ते साधव समदर्शिना सद्भिक्षिणोति तं तर्षं तत आराद् विशुध्यति दरिद्रस्यैव युज्यन्ते साधव समदर्शिना सद्भिक्षिणोति तं तर्षं तत आराद् विशुध्यति दरिद्रस्यैव युज्यन्ते साधव समदर्शिनः सद्भिक्षिणोति तं तर्षं तत आराद् विशुध्यति दरिद्रस्यैव युज्यन्ते साधव समदर्शिना Sat bhikshinoti tam tarsham tata aradvishuddhyati daridra saiva yujyante sadhava samadarshina sat bhikshinoti tam tarsham tata aradvishuddhyati daridrasya eva yujyante sadhava samadarshina sad bhikshinoti tam tarsham tata aradvishuddhyati daridrasya of a person who is poverty stricken eva indeed yujyante may easily associate sadhava saintly persons samadarshina although sadhus are equal to everyone to the poor and the rich The poor man can take advantage of their association. Sadbhi, by the association of such saintly persons. Kshinoti, reduces. Tam, the original cause of material suffering. Tarsham, the desire for material enjoyment tata thereafter arat very soon visuddhyati his material contamination is cleansed off translation and purport by his divine grace Srila Prabhupada Saintly persons may freely associate with those who are poverty stricken, but not with those who are rich. A poverty stricken man, by association with saintly persons, very soon becomes uninterested in material desires, and the dirty things within the core of his heart are cleansed away. It is said, Mahad Vichalanam Nirnam Grahinam. Dina Chetasam. Srimad Bhagavatam, 10th canto, 8th chapter, 4th verse. The only business of a saintly person or sannyasi, a person in the renounced order, is to preach Krishna consciousness. Sadhus, saintly persons, want to preach to both the poor and the rich. But the poor take more advantage of the sadhus preaching than the rich do. A poor man receives sadhus very quickly, offers them obeisances, and tries to take advantage of their presence. Whereas a rich man keeps a big greyhound dog at his door so that no one can enter his house. He posts a sign saying, "Beware of dog," and avoids the association of saintly persons. Whereas a poor man keeps his door open for them and thus benefits by their association more than a rich man does. Because Narada Muni in his previous life was the poverty-stricken son of a maidservant, he got the association of saintly persons and later became the exalted Narada Muni. This was his actual experience. Therefore, he is now comparing the position of a poor man with that of a rich man. Satam prasangan mama virya samvido bhavanti hritkarna rasayana katha tajoshanad aswa apavargas vartmani shraddha ratir bhaktir anukramishati. Srimad Bhagavatam, 3rd canto, 25th chapter, 25th verse. If one gets the advantage of association with saintly persons by their instructions, one becomes more and more purified of material desires. कृष्ण बहिर्मुख हय भोगवांछा करे निकटस्थ माया तारे झपटिया धरे ప్రేమ వివర్త. మటీరియల్ లైఫ్ మీన్స్ దట్ వన్ ఫర్గెట్స్ కృష్ణ అండ్ దట్ వన్ ఇన్క్రీసెస్ ఇన్ వన్స్ డిజైర్స్ ఫర్ సెన్స్ గ్రాటిఫికేషన్. బట్ ఇఫ్ వన్ రిసీవ్స్ ద అడ్వాంటేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్స్ట్రక్షన్స్ ఫ్రమ్ సెయింట్లీ పర్సన్స్ అండ్ ఫర్గెట్స్ ద ఇంపార్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ మటీరియల్ డిజైర్స్, వన్ ఈస్ ఆటోమేటికలీ ప్యూరిఫైడ్. చేతో దర్పణ మార్జనం భవ మహా దావాగ్ని నిర్వాపణం. శిక్షాశకం ద ఫస్ట్ వర్స్. So unless the core of a materialistic person's heart is purified, he cannot get rid of the pangs of bhava mahadavagni, the blazing fire of material existence. Om agnana timirandhasya gnananjana shalakaya chakshuron militam yena tasmai shri gurave namaha. శ్రీ చైతన్య మనోభీష్టం స్థాపితం యేన భూతలే స్వయం రూపా కదా మయ్యం దదాతి స్వపదాంతికం. వందేహం శ్రీగురు శ్రీయుత పదకమలం శ్రీగురున్ వైష్ణవాంశ్చ శ్రీరూప సాగ్రజాతాం సహగణ రఘునాథాన్వితాం తాం సజీవం సాద్వైతం సావధూతం పరిజనా సహితం కృష్ణ చైతన్య దేవం. శ్రీ రాధా కృష్ణ పాదాన్ సహగణ లలిత శ్రీ విశాఖాన్వితాంశ్చ. హే కృష్ణ కరుణా సింధు దీనబంధు జగత్పతే గోపేశ గోపికాకాంత రాధాకాంత నమోస్తుతే. తప్త కాంచన గౌరాంగీ రాధే వృందావనేశ్వరి వృషభానుసుతే దేవి ప్రణమామి హరిప్రియే. వాంఛాకల్పతరుభ్యశ్చ కృపా సింధూభ్య ఏవ చ పతితానాం పావనేభ్యో వైష్ణవేభ్యో నమో నమః. జయ శ్రీ కృష్ణ చైతన్య ప్రభో నిత్యానంద శ్రీ అద్వైత గదాధర్ శ్రీవాసది గౌరభక్తవృంద. హరే కృష్ణ 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 హరే హరే, హరే రామ హరే రామ 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 హరే హరే. హరే కృష్ణ. సో ఫస్ట్ ఐ వుడ్ లైక్ టు టేక్ బ్లెస్సింగ్స్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ ది అసెంబ్ల్డ్ వైష్ణవాస్ బిఫోర్ వి కెన్ స్పీక్ ఆన్ ది శ్రీమద్ భాగవతం. సో ఓవర్ ది పాస్ట్ ఫ్యూ డేస్ వి హ్యావ్ బీన్ హియరింగ్ దిస్ పాస్ట్ టైమ్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ నారద ముని, హౌ హీ సీస్ ది టూ సన్స్ ఆఫ్ కుబేర అండ్ how they, you know, they are basically, their behavior is not, of course, not pleasing to him. And in these verses, or the past few, you know, verses, Narada Muni is basically sharing what he is thinking, and this will culminate in his giving a curse. So we are seeing that how Narada Muni is not giving the curse like out of anger or impulsively. He is actually going through like a nice deliberation as to why he is giving the curse and how it can benefit these two sons of Kuvera. And in this specific verse, he is basically based on his experience that he was also born in his previous life. Narada Muni was the son of a maid servant, and how he received the association of saintly persons and how he was able to basically perfect his life. And he is seeing that these people, these two sons of Kuvera, who are, you know, rich, who have, you know, youth, and they are trying to misuse that. So he wants to correct them, and hence we have this, you know, sharing of Narada Muni's thought that saintly persons are equal to everyone, because when we preach, when we go for book distribution or when we preach, we don't distinguish, right? But the reception differs. For example, if they say, how do we pick up, so, for example, we have, you know, there is some signal going on of the, let's say, the TV or the radio or some wireless. But if you have the right receiver, then actually we can receive it. So similarly, Krishna's mercy is there everywhere throughout. Devotees are available to give that mercy. But it depends on the receiver's receptivity. If the receiver is prepared to receive, then actually that person can make maximum benefit of the availability of Krishna consciousness through the sadhus. There is a similar verse in Queen Kunti's prayers, Janma Aishwarya Shruta Shribhir. So she says that if a person is proud because of his either birth or education or beauty or wealth. These are four factors mentioned by Kunti Devi. Then the person becomes actually tries to avoid, because of his pride he cannot receive mercy. And then at the end of the same verse she says that Krishna is the property of Akinchana Gochara. So Krishna is Akinchana Gochara, means Krishna is easily accessible to people who are materially exhausted. Now of course we have seen they said that a snake is envious, and if a snake has a jewel, he is furthermore envious because he wants to take care of the jewel. So similarly, we have taken birth in this material world as conditioned souls for the desire to enjoy. And if we have facilities to enjoy through these multiple channels without proper guidance, then naturally we will enjoy. And that's what we see in this world, that people who have these opulences without the proper guidance of saintly persons, they actually end up using it to their desires to sense enjoyment. Whereas Srila Prabhupada mentions in the purport that this desire can be purified by the association of saintly persons. If we look at our literatures in the entire Srimad Bhagavatam, we find that actually all the devotees are kings. But what's the difference? They were kings, they had opulence, they had all the power and wealth. But just because they were guided by Brahmanas, because of Vedic culture, they were able to actually execute as heads of the state, help everyone lead a spiritual life. Even if we go back, 500 years ago, with the time of Lord Chaitanya, we will find that Lord Chaitanya also had, among his many followers, he had one devotee who was also born as a king. And who is he? Maharaj Pratap Rudra. So Pratap Rudra was also born in a royal culture, royal family. In fact, he ruled for 40 plus years in the land of Orissa. And when we read history, not the devotional part, the regular history by mundane scholars, they actually focus on Lord Pratap Rudra's monarchy, his valor, and how he was able to conquer his neighboring kingdoms, how he was able to keep the Mughals, the Muslims, Hussain Shah, who was in Bengal, one border of Orissa, how he was able to keep check on Hussain Shah, and how he was also able to, on the southern kingdom, there was a king called Krishnadevaraya, he also fought with him. So Maharaj Pratap Rudra was a very powerful and valiant king. However, his devotional qualities are not mentioned in the mundane books. Through acharyas, we understand that he was a great devotee. And today we'll spend some time briefly describing his glories and how he was, though he was born in a rich family, a king family, how he was able to receive Lord Chaitanya's mercy. So Lord Chaitanya left Mayapur, Navadvip, and after he took sannyas, he went to Jagannath Puri. Of course, there's a story about how he went to Vrindavan and he came back. But finally, a lot of his later pastimes are in Jagannath Puri. And King Pratap Rudra, being the king of Orissa, he was naturally a born devotee of Lord Jagannath. Basically, Lord Jagannath is the presiding deity of Orissa. So anyone who is born there is kind of naturally devoted to Jagannath. So when Pratap Rudra Maharaj saw the Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he actually saw him one time dancing. And he saw that the Lord was dancing, his body was filled with dust, and also there was saliva from his mouth because of ecstasy. So he was bewildered. He was not sure, what is this? So the Lord is in the heart of everyone, and so Krishna could understand what is in the heart of Pratap Rudra Maharaj. So that night, he has a dream. And in his dream, he sees that Lord Jagannath is also, his body is full of dust and there is saliva. So he gets disturbed by seeing this vision. So he wants to go, out of affection for his Ishtadev, Lord Jagannath, he wants to go and try to clean the Lord. And then Lord Jagannath says, Pratap Rudra, wait, are you sure what you are doing? You are a king and my body is so dirty. Are you sure you want to touch me? So then he kind of, you know, start thinking, oh, what is this? And then suddenly in front of his eyes, he sees Lord Jagannath turn into Lord Chaitanya. And then he sees Lord Chaitanya sitting in a throne. So then when he wakes up, he's kind of, you know, confused. He says, okay, what did I see? What do I make of my dream? So then he goes to his spiritual master, Sarvam Bhattacharya, and then he, you know, explains his account. You know, I saw all this. Please explain to me, what do I make out of this? Then his guru, Sarvam Bhattacharya, explains that, oh, my dear king, Lord Chaitanya is the supreme personality of Godhead, Sri Jagannath. And he has taken appearance just to deliver the, for all the fallen souls through the propagation of Harinam Sankirtan. So you are very fortunate to get this vision. So when Maharaj Pratapadra hears this, his doubts are cleared. He is now understands what he is seeing. So then he pleads. He says that, my dear spiritual master, can you please help me have darshan of the Lord, meeting with him once? He says, okay, let me approach Mahaprabhu. Then he goes and then he approaches Mahaprabhu. And he says, oh my Lord, the king wants to have your meeting with you. Then Mahaprabhu is not very happy with the idea. He's not happy with this idea of meeting the king. So he says that, Sarvabhauma, what are you saying? Associating with a materialistic person is same as drinking poison, or maybe even worse. By drinking poison, you are actually causing only material death. But when you associate closely, mix very closely with a person who is like a king, who is the height of materialism, then it will cause spiritual death. So definitely, I would not meet with the king, and please do not mention this to me one more time. So when he hears this, now here Pratapadra Maharaj is eagerly waiting that what will my guru say, what is the good news? But when he meets Sarvam Bhattacharya, he says that, no, the Lord doesn't want to meet you. So the king is completely devastated. So if it was maybe an ordinary king who is proud of his wealth and his aristocracy and his position, he would have probably said differently. But Maharaj Pratapadra, being of a devotional quality, saintly king, he says that he was basically, you know, he starts almost, you know, very, very dejected, and he replies, what is the use of my life if I cannot get the Lord's mercy? If by becoming a king is coming in the way of having the Lord's darshan, then I'm ready to give up my kingdom and become a mendicant. Even if that is not adequate, I'm ready to actually give up my life. I have heard that you only mentioned that Lord Chaitanya has come here to deliver all the fallen souls, and he has delivered Jagai Madhai. But how come he is ready to give his mercy to the whole world except this lowly Pratapadra? So when his guru hears this mood of his disciple, he's actually very pleased internally. And he says, oh my dear king, just because you have this dridha vratta or determination, one day surely you will receive the Lord's mercy. So this gives hope to Maharaj Pratapadra, and he says, okay, let me wait for that day. With time, Lord Chaitanya, of course, went to South India, and then there he met Ramananda Rai, and the Lord told Ramananda Rai to actually wind up. So Ramananda Rai was also in a royal position. He was the governor of a South Indian province. So the Lord inspired him to leave that and come to stay with him, live with him in Jagannath Puri. Now, Maharaj Pratapadra is also close to Ramananda Rai, because they were both being in the royal person, they used to have no interact with each other. So when Maharaj Pratapadra hears about this from Ramananda Rai, he actually embraces Ramananda Rai, and he has tears in his eyes. Not because of any envy, but because of, he is actually happy that, my dear Ramananda, it is so nice that you have received the Lord's mercy. If he has told you that you can leave everything and come here, let me assure you that you will receive your full salaryless pension when you retire from that service. I will ensure that you get full salary so that financially you will never have any encumbrance, any hindrances. So this again, we see how the king's devotional qualities are that he was not comparing that, oh, I am a king, even Ramananda Rai was a governor, why is the Lord merciful to him than me? So he didn't compare that. In fact, he was trying to facilitate so that Ramananda Rai can serve the Lord and get full mercy from the Lord. We see more of these episodes of King Pratapudra as time proceeds. So the devotees are actually discussing about Maharaj. They see that the king is so nice. So they are discussing about this. So Mahaprabhu hears this, devotees discussing something in a hushed manner. So he asks, what's happening? Please tell me, what are we discussing? So Nityananda Prabhu has some courage. He says, oh my Lord, this king, he's a king. So if he doesn't get what he wants, you don't know what he may do. He may do something very strange. So can you please give him your darshan one time? So again, Lord Chaitanya is he's not happy. He says that you people do what you want to do. You are all wise people. So let me tell me what I should do. Then of course they say, oh my Lord, you are independent. We cannot tell anything to you. But since you don't want to meet him, at least maybe you can give some paraphernalia of yours. Maybe you can give a part of your upper cloth. So that way he gets pacified. He says, okay, do whatever you want to do. So then they give a part of Mahaprabhu's upper cloth to the king. And the king is very happy. He says, okay, whatever I get, I am very grateful. And let me worship that. Now also Ramananda Rai, knowing that the king is such saintly, Ramananda Rai also tells to Mahaprabhu when there is an opportunity that, oh my Lord, the king actually is a Raja Rishi. He is a king, but actually he is not so materialistic as most people think. Please, you should probably meet him at least once. Otherwise, he'll be completely, heartbroken. So Mahaprabhu again replies. Mahaprabhu says that, my dear Ramananda, you know that even the slightest fault of a sannyasi, the world will magnify. Just like even a drop of liquor falls in a whole pot of milk, the entire milk is contaminated. Also, similarly, if you have a very clean white cloth, even a small dark dot on that, it's very visible. Similarly, I am a sannyasi. You want to meet me only once, but that even one meeting may not be perceived by the population as something nice, and hence it will be a blemish on the character of a sannyasi, and hence I cannot meet him. However, if you insist, then maybe you can send his son to me. His son is considered the representative of the father, as good as the father. So maybe, if you send him, that may help the king. So that arrangement is made. The king's son, he is of course a small boy. He comes wearing a silk or yellow dhoti. He is also darkest complexion. So he dressed up as Krishna. So when he comes, Mahaprabhu embraces him. And that boy suddenly develops ecstatic symptoms. So when he goes home, the king is very happy. Yes, he embraces his son. He says, okay, this way I get some indirect mercy of the Lord. So this way we find how the king is waiting patiently to get Mahaprabhu's mercy. During Snan Yatra, we have the festival here every year in our New Dwarka Dham. Snan Yatra, there is a pastime of Lord Jagannath getting sick. So Mahaprabhu goes to Alarnath to have darshan there. At that time, devotees from Bengal actually arrive to Jagannath Puri for the Rath Yatra festival. So when the devotees arrive, the Lord sends two of his devotees to receive the devotees from Bengal. The two devotees who go are Swarup Damodar Goswami and Govinda. So king is sitting with Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. At that time, Gopinath Acharya enters the room and he says, my dear king, around 200 devotees from Bengal have come, and so we need to make living arrangements for them. They are all associates of Sri Mahaprabhu. The king is very happy to hear that. The king says, these people are very dear to Mahaprabhu because they know him from his childhood days. I would like to go and see them. So then they go to the rooftop. From there, they are seeing what's happening. And so he sees that two devotees from Mahaprabhu's side, they are coming with garlands in their hand. And we have 200 devotees here from Bengal who are here. And so then he asks Gopinath Acharya. So the king asks to Gopinath Acharya. So Gopinath Acharya, who is this man who is standing in the front with garland in his hand? He says, he replies that his name is Swarup Damodar Goswami. He is a very dear associate of the Lord. Just okay. So then Swarup Damodar Goswami garlands Advaita Acharya, because he is the leader of all the devotees from Bengal. And then of course Govinda is somewhat new to the whole crowd here. So Advaita Acharya asks, who is this person with you who has the garland? So he replies that he is Govinda. He was a disciple of Ishwarapuri, but now he is serving Mahaprabhu. So he also garlands Advaita Acharya. And the king asks, what's happening? Who is this Varishtha Vaishnava who received two garlands? Then he explains that, you know, this is Advaita Acharya, who is the leader of all the devotees from Bengal. And then of course, Gopinath Acharya goes on explaining all the devotees' names and the qualities of Bengal. The king is very ecstatic to hear all that. He says, please ensure that they all get first class service and first class accommodation, and their stay in Orissa in Jagannath Puri is completely very blissful. So now we are preparing for the Jagannath Puri Rath Yatra festival. During the Rath Yatra festival, Maharaj Pratap Rudra ensures that the king, that Mahaprabhu and his followers, they get a close darshan of Jagannath as he moves from the temple to the cart. Anyone here who has been to Jagannath Puri during the Rath Yatra festivals? So we see how it is so crowded. So you need to really have some crowd control to be able to manage situations. That's probably, it is said, it is a world record of the largest number of people at any point of time assembled at one place. So that is the glory of Lord Jagannath. Shri Jagannath Devaki Jai. So we find here that when Mahaprabhu is dancing in front of Lord Jagannath during the Rath Yatra festival, there are seven kirtan parties with seven kirtan leaders, and Mahaprabhu is in the center dancing, and they make three circles or three groups to ensure that Mahaprabhu, nobody, you know, falls on Mahaprabhu, that there is enough clearance around Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's dancing. So the first circle or the first group is led by Nityananda Prabhu himself. The second group of such, you know, volunteers is led by Kashi Mishra and Srivas Kashi Mishra. And the third group is actually led by King and his minister. So King's minister is Harichandan. So the king and his minister, they are there. They are doing the service of, you know, managing the crowd near Mahaprabhu where he is dancing. Now all the devotees are seeing Mahaprabhu dancing. And somehow we see that in front of the king is Srivas Thakur. And he is seeing Lord Chaitanya's dance. And Harichandan, the minister of the king, he finds that, you know, Srivas Thakur is obstructing the vision of the king seeing the Lord dance. He tries to push him aside. He says, oh, no, please be aside so that the king can see the dance. Now Srivas Thakur is in ecstasy. He doesn't really listen. He just keeps on, doesn't get aside. So now this time Harichandan actually pushes him really physically aside. So he doesn't even take care. He continues. So still there's a problem. So he again now forcibly, Harichandan tries to really brush him aside and says that, no, the king wants to see. Please aside. Please move aside. Now Srivas Thakur now loses his cool. He turns around and he slaps the minister on his, like a big slap. Now you can imagine, suppose it happens here. We have Janmashtami, the maximum crowd here. And suppose the mayor comes here and the sheriff also comes with him. And the sheriff wants to have darshan. And suppose one of the devotees in ecstasy, they slap the mayor. So something similar, you can imagine what's happening here. But here, king could have been offended, right? Saying that, oh, you are disrespecting my minister. It's like disrespecting me. But again, the king naturally is a devotee. So the king actually says, Harichandan, you are very fortunate. Says, why? You have got the direct touch from the Lord's devotee. So you should be grateful. He tries to change the mood completely. Now we don't know whether Harichandan was grateful or not, but definitely he didn't retaliate. So the situation was taken care, and there was no retaliation. So So this way, then the dancing continues. And then at some point, Mahaprabhu, while dancing, he actually falls, was about to fall down. And the king holds on. He was able to hold Mahaprabhu to prevent him from falling down to the ground. And then the Lord immediately sees the king. And he gets up and he says, he's like, Vishnu, that I have been touched by a Vishayi. So basically he acts as if, it was like somebody very contaminating has touched him. So again, the king is, feeling bad about it. However, we find that the king gets some special mercy. And what is that? The king is able to see two things. One, he sees that while Lord Chaitanya is dancing, he is actually simultaneously present in all the kirtan parties. Every kirtan party thought, there are 7 kirtan parties. So every kirtan party thought that the Lord is dancing only in their part, in their group. Only Maharaj Prataprudra gets vision. He sees the Lord expand to 7 different forms. So he is completely in ecstasy. The second thing he sees is that when he sees Lord Jagannath, he starts seeing Lord Jagannath and Lord Chaitanya are indifferent, non-different. So then actually he immediately goes to his guru and he asks, I'm seeing all this. What is this? He says, his guru replies that the Lord may be externally very, very, indifferent to you. He may be treating you, as a very contaminating person. But actually internally he is pleased. And that is why you are seeing this vision. So please ignore the Lord's external behavior. But you should be happy that you have this vision of seeing the Lord manifest himself simultaneously in 7 different kirtans. You are a very special king. The king again gets some courage and hope. And he continues. Now the Rathyatra continues. And at some point the cart stops so that devotees can make offerings. And Lord Chaitanya goes to the Jagannath Vallabh garden nearby to take rest. At that point, Sarvam Bhattacharya and the devotees, now they explain the king. He said, the king, this is your opportunity. You change your dress from being a king. Wear ordinary clothes and go and massage the Lord's lotus feet and sing the Gopi Gita. So the king says, okay, let me do whatever you say. And then the king then goes there. He changes his clothes, becomes a very regular person. And the Lord is resting under a tree and he's relaxing himself. The king goes there and he starts massaging the Lord's lotus feet. So the Lord says, and he starts singing the Gopi Gita. So the Lord is very happy, he's blissful, in ecstasy. He says, oh, keep on singing, keep on singing, keep on singing. Now the king is encouraged further. And when he comes to the 9th verse, Tava Krathamritam, Tapta Jivanam, then the last verse is Bhurida Jana. So when the Lord hears this verse and the last verse, Bhurida Jana, so this verse basically means that people who are preaching the cruel glories of Krishna, they are very dear to the Lord, because they are the most compassionate to the fallen souls. So the word Bhurida Jana means the most compassionate to the fallen souls. So when Mahaprabhu hears this verse, he is at the culmination of his ecstasy. He comes and embraces the king and he starts saying, Bhurida Jana, you are Bhurida, you are Bhurida, you are that merciful person. Please keep on singing. The king is so happy and then his desires are fulfilled. So this way we find that Maharaj Prataprudra, even though he was born in such a position, but just because he had the guidance of his guru and he was respectful towards saintly persons, he had the reception, he had the receiver, he had the ability to receive Lord Chaitanya's mercy. And in this verse also we hear the same understanding. Srila Prabhupada says that unless a saintly person gives mercy to rich or poor, anyone, one cannot get the Lord's mercy, one cannot get his or her heart purified. So this way, we understand how to understand this verse, how Narad Muni is explaining that how the people who are actually akinchana, people who are materially exhausted, can, or who feel who are actually poor in their heart, devoid of any spiritual wealth, how they can actually receive Krishna's mercy. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Are there any questions or comments? Srila Prabhupada ki.